The greatest trophy in all of sports, the most historic, the most coveted. First of all, congratulations to Jeff Finnick, who I know is with his family back in Tampa, to Julian Breesbaugh, John Cooper, the rest of the hockey operations organization, the coaching staff. I know everybody here misses your families back in Tampa and you can't wait to see them. And we miss having our fans in the building. We have the greatest fans in the world. Our game gets incredible energy from you, and we can't wait to have you back. Tampa has asked, under the circumstances, to do it a little bit different this year. So before I formally present the Stanley Cup, I'd like to invite you all up here to surround the cup, and then I'll make the official presentation.
Might as well do it a little differently because everything else about this has been different from the norm.
What?
No.
Not yet.
Okay, 1 second. We'll do it. There's no harder championship to win. The gauntlet that you have to run to hoist this trophy is unbelievable, and never more unbelievable than this year. These guys have been away from home for more than 2 months. This has been the ultimate team effort. This Stanley Cup run will go down in the record books as perhaps the hardest run of all times. You guys should all be incredibly proud. This has been an amazing accomplishment. It is my honor to present the Stanley Cup to Steven Stamkos.
Doesn't look any different. I'm sure it doesn't feel any different for the players, and there was never any doubt who was getting the cup next.
Yeah, all the emotions that have been built up your entire life trying to get to this moment as a player, your family, your friends, your coaches and teammates.
There's a cool pass to a veteran who got into the playoffs but didn't get a chance to play in the Stanley Cup final, Braden Coburn. Ryan McDonough, Minnesotan, who's had 140 playoff games, finally a Stanley Cup. There's one of the original core from Beaconsfield, Quebec, Alex Killorn.
How about Luke Shen? His brother triumphant in 7 last year in St. Louis. He played a big role coming into the lineup when they needed him. And a big part of this win.
Zach Bogosian, another one of the late ads, as a free agent at the trade deadline from Buffalo, played a big role, and he got to play in the game tonight. And back-to-back lifts of the Stanley Cup for Pat Maroon, who won with St. Louis last year, comes to Tampa and wins the cup again. Nikita Kucherov has been through the roller coaster ride and the disappointments and the great seasons. And there's their great goaltender, Andrei Vasilevsky, who got the shutout tonight. Andre Palat left the Czech Republic at 18 years old to play in Drummondville, a 208th draft pick.
And Tyler Johnson had held the goal record for Tampa Bay from 2015-13. He got beat by that man there. Got his 14th, the Stanley Cup game-winning goal for Braden Point.
Too small, too slow, 79th draft pick, and the best 79th ever, I'd say.
Well, you never know where your year is going to go for Kevin Shattenkirk. It from one disappointment and a buyout to an opportunity here in Tampa and a Stanley Cup championship.
There's another one of the long timers, Cedric Paquette. From the Gas Peninsula in Quebec. Yanni Gord, St. Narcisse near Trois-Rivières, undrafted out of Victoriaville, developed within the system. Consummate teammate, Curtis McElhaney. Moved around as a backup, and now he's got a Stanley Cup. And his parents are,
you can sense
few
a little
of the family and friends
yeah,
here.
Yeah, you can sense a little extra with Curtis and being able to go down and share it with his family. That's a great moment.
Barclay Goodrow from Aurora, Ontario. Spent 5 years with the battalion in Brampton and North Bay playing for Stan Butler, and that prepared him for this.
What a moment. Well, the newcomers really proved that Julien Brisebois knew what he was doing, spending the picks and the deals to get both Coleman and Goodrow pay off with a Stanley Cup championship.
Chernak, a throw-in and a deal for Ben Bishop, it seemed like, with Los Angeles. Turned into a regular defenseman, and he's got a Stanley Cup. Anthony Cirelli, runner-up in the Selke Trophy voting. Big goals and winning, just follow him around. Mikhail Sergachev played his first National Hockey League game with the Montreal Canadiens, and now a Stanley Cup champion with Tampa. What a night for this young man.
What a beautiful night, huh?
23-year-old Russian into his first playoff game, and it was game six, the deciding game of the Stanley Cup. Waterdown, Ontario's Carter Verhaeghe, drafted by the Leafs, traded to the Islanders, traded to Tampa, and happy to be there, Matthew Joseph, one of the aces who practiced, took warm-ups just about every night, didn't get a chance to play.
This, more than any year, was the most difficult for the extra players who weren't around their families. All they had to do was work out and
hang out in the bubble.
And how about this pass to the head coach?
Prince George, British Columbia's John Cooper. What a route to the Stanley Cup. Became the coach of this team in the 2012-13 season. And finally reached the ultimate goal. Let's go down onto the ice and Scott Oak with Victor Hedman, the Conn Smythe Trophy winner.
Thank you, Jim. Victor, you've had a lot of close calls over the years. Just tell me how it feels to you to finally win the Stanley Cup.
Yeah, it's tough to explain. It's a dream come true. It's the best thing I've experienced in my hockey career. And you know, what we've done as a team, you know, inside a bubble, it's been unbelievable. So I'm at loss for words. It's going to take a long time for it to sink in.
Conn Smythe Trophy obviously recognizes your level of play in the Stanley Cup playoffs. How driven were you personally to win this year after losing in 2015 and being swept by Columbus last year?
No, we're a determined group. We added some pieces that really added to our game the way we wanted to play. And you know, I can't give enough credit to every single guy back there. It's been a team effort all the way, and we couldn't get there without every single one of us. So, so happy right now. And like I said, it's going to take a long time for it to sink in.
How would you describe this run in which no series went the distance?
I couldn't hear you there.
How would you describe this run for the Tampa Bay Lightning in which no series went the distance, Victor?
No, we're a resilient group. We're determined to finish a job when we have the opportunity, and we played unbelievable teams on the way here. And Dallas is, you know, a great team with a lot of young talent, and you know, a great great leadership. So, you know, it was a tough one for us, but we're so happy.
Thank you, Victor. Appreciate your
time. Thanks, Scott.
Appreciate Congratulations.
He's going to NBC first.
Oh, Jim, sorry. Go ahead.
Okay. The cup is still being passed around. It is such a very different atmosphere. Usually about this time, the doors open and the families and friends who have been flown in on charter flights, if you're on the road, or if you're in your home city, they flood onto the ice. And then there's those wonderful scenes of the hugging, and we always hear the interviews, and the players usually pay tribute to their parents who have driven them to the rinks and who have paved the way for them to win a Stanley Cup. That will happen, but it'll happen in a different manner for all of these players. We're not sure what lies ahead, but we know over the last 9 weeks that it has been amazing to watch the level of play from a lot of players who felt isolated, but felt the opportunity was still there to legitimately play seven-game series and win the Stanley Cup.
There's one of the rare moments, the Goodrow family getting a emotional embrace. Says it all, doesn't it?
Salute to and hats off to and a stick tap to the trainers and the medical staffs of all of these teams. They were isolated too. They had more work to do. They had to sanitize, move dressing rooms. They didn't have to travel, but they too were in the bubble and had a harder, more difficult, more different job than they've ever had in a Stanley Cup playoff. Steven Stamkos, there was never a doubt in my mind he was going to be in his equipment and come out on the ice to accept the Stanley Cup, and here he is with Scott.